Dear students, so in this lecture we will discuss about the stability and reactivity of organometallic compounds. So stability means how far the organometallic compound can remain as such, and reactivity means how fast an organometallic compound can react. So reactivity is related to the kinetic stability. So, if the organometallic compound is more reactive, then it is kinetically unstable compound. So, the reactivity we will discuss in this section, we will discuss about the stability and reactivity of main group organometallic compounds, S or P block element compounds. So, the reactivity that depends upon nature of MC bond. So, in case of S and P block elements or any other organometallic compounds, the reactivity or kinetic instability or stability, it depends upon the type of MC bond. So, if the MC bond is ionic, the organometallic compound will be more reactive. So, the factors that increases the ionic nature of MC bond, they will be responsible for increasing the reactivity of organometallic compound. So we will discuss one by one the factors that affects the order of ionic bond between M and C, how they affect, what are the factors that affect the nature of ionic bond. If the ionic bond nature increases, then reactivity will also increase. So it is the reactivity of an organometallic compound, it is directly proportional to the ionic bond. So because we are discussing about the stability of main group organometallic compound, so we are mixing it with the ionic bond nature of MC bond. So very reactive means, very reactive organometallic compounds means it is kinetically unstable, and there will be more ionic character in between M and C bond. So stability and reactivity depends upon MC bond strength. So more ionic, more reactive. So this is the fundamental principle in case of main group organometallics, then that more ionic the organometallic compound, more reactive it will be. So what are the factor that affects the MC bond strength, which affects the ionic nature of MC bond? So those are metal or cation and type of organic molecule. Because the organometallic compound is made up of metal and ligand or organic molecule, so only two factors are there which affects the stability or reactivity of main group organometallic compounds, that are metal or cations and type of organic molecule. So first of all, we will discuss about the metal cations. So what are the properties of metal cation that increases the ionic character of MC bond and which further increases the reactivity of organometallic compound? So the first factor is size. So if the size of cation is very large, we have already studied about the Fajans rule. So in the Fajans rule, the smaller the cation, the more will be the covalent character. So in this case, if the size of cation will be large, then ionic character will increase because covalent character will decrease. So MC bond become more reactive because ionic character will increase. So we see the series like this: dimethyl mercury, dimethyl cadmium, dimethyl zinc, dimethyl magnesium and methyl lithium. So in this series, the most reactive organometallic compound will be methyl lithium, because the size of lithium is large as compared to Mg, as compared to these elements. So we have compared these Zn, Cd and Hg with these because they are supposed to be like, they act like they act like s and p block elements because their d orbitals are filled. So these are compared with these two. So we can compare these two only for main group elements. So we can find that Li plus ion is larger in size as compared to Mg2 plus ion. So the bond between C and Li will be more ionic. So it will become more reactive. So this CH3Li will be less stable as compared to this complex. Now the second point is reactivity increases from the lightest to heaviest element. So from lightest to heaviest in case of s and p block elements, this is the case of s and p block elements, where from top to bottom, as we go from top to bottom, from lightest to heaviest element, then the MC bond strength will weaken because the size is also increasing. So as the size increases, the MC bond strength decreases, it becomes more ionic, and from top to bottom, the ionic character of the MC bond will increase. So the stability will decrease, or we can say that the reactivity will increase. So if we compare LiCH3 and KCH3, because it is the heaviest one and it is the lightest one, so stability of KCH3 will be less as compared to LiCH3. So as we go from top to bottom, from lightest to heaviest, the order of reactivity will increase and order of stability will decrease. Then the third point is that electron deficiency or vacant orbitals in a metal atom or metal cation of an organometallic compound, it causes more reactivity of the organometallic compound. Due to electron deficiency, the reactivity of the organometallic compound increases. So as in case of, we can see that Li, Na, Mg, Al alkyls, they react with air or water. As we have already discussed, we have already studied that Li, Na, Mg, Al, they form electron deficient compounds. So electron deficient compounds, they can easily react because they are coordinatively unsaturated compounds. So they can easily react, they have chances to react with the other species, so their reactivity increases. So these alkyls are highly reactive. When we see this Al2CH3 whole 6, it is also electron deficient compound, so it react violently in air, so their reactivity increases. SiCH3 whole 4, this is SiCH3 whole 4, it will not react with water at room temperature because Si has no vacant orbitals. So these are the three factors which affect the nature of metal carbon bonding in main group or S or P block organometallic compounds, that are size of cation, that is the lightest or heaviest element, and third one is the electron deficient nature of the metal atom. The other factor that affects the nature of metal carbon bond is organic molecule. The organic molecule that is attached to the metal atom. So the organic molecule may play an important role in the reactivity of organometallic compound in case of main group organometallic compounds. So the charge on the organic molecule, especially on the carbon atom that is attached to the metal center, so that affects the nature of metal carbon bonding. So more negative charge on the metal bonded carbon atom of the molecule, it leads to the higher ionic character of MC bond. So higher will be the negative charge on the organic molecule's carbon atom that is attached to the metal, the more ionic character of the MC bond will be there. And more ionic character means more reactivity of the organometallic compound. So we can explain it with the help of this example. So we can see that C6H5CH2 negative charge in on this C, which is attached to this metal atom. So reactivity of this compound is more as compared to this compound. So why it is so? Because the negative charge of this anion, benzyl anion, so we can see that C6H5CH2, this negative charge resides only on this carbon atom, which is directly attached to this metal atom. While in case of C6H5-, so this is a benzene ring, and negative charge in this benzene ring will be delocalized on these six carbon atoms. So this negative charge is distributed or delocalized on the six carbon atoms, while this negative charge resides only on this carbon atom, which is directly bonded to the sodium. So the negative charge or electron density will be higher on this carbon atom, while in case of the carbon atom that is attached to this sodium, the density of electron or the negative charge will be less in that carbon atom, because this negative charge is delocalized on these six carbon atoms. So the ionic character of this compound will decrease and its ionic character will increase. So it will be more reactive as compared to this. So we can also say that aryl compounds are less reactive than the alkyl compounds. So this is an alkyl compound. CH2 is directly bonded to metal, while in this case this benzene ring is directly attached to this sodium. So this is aryl compound and this is an alkyl compound. So an aryl compound is more stable as compared to an alkyl compound. So alkyl organometallics are more reactive as compared to the aryl compounds. Then next point, that organomolecule, how they affect the MC bond nature, is the carbon ion with extended conjugated system form stable organometallic compound. So if the carbon that is attached directly to the metal atom, if it has extended conjugation system, conjugated system, or in you can see that carbon atom, if it is sp hybridized, it will be less reactive, and if it is sp2 hybridized, then it is more reactive, and if it is sp3 hybridized, then it will be the highly reactive organometallic compound. So it depends upon the carbon atom which is attached to the metal center. So if it is sp hybridized, then it will be less reactive, because back bonding will be going to form. Back bonding means strengthen the metal carbon bond, that is pi bond, that is covalent bond. So this will decrease the ionic nature. So if there is extended conjugated system, so it will decrease the ionic nature of the MC bond, and thus it increases the stability of organometallic compound. So for example, if the ligand is phenyl, in case of phenyl, C is sp2 hybridized. In case of methyl, C is sp3 hybridized. So sp2 hybridized carbon atom will form covalent bond with the metal center. And this sp3 hybridized carbon atom will form ionic bond with the metal center. So it will become more reactive and it will become more stable. So compounds where carbon ion with extended conjugated system was there, then they form stable organometallic compounds. Now the third factor, as we know that the negative charge or the electron density on the carbon atom that is bonded to the metal center of organometallic compound, if the negative charge increased, then ionic character will also increase. If negative charge decreased, then covalent character will increase. So if covalent character will increase, then stability will increase. If ionic character will increase, then reactivity will increase. So if the negative charge or electron density on the attached carbon atom can be decreased by loss of H plus or addition of electronegative atoms like F minus and Cl minus ion. So we can decrease the negative charge on the carbon atom that is directly attached to the metal atom. So if we add electronegative groups or we remove H plus ion, then we can form such kind of molecule in which the negative charge on the carbon atom will decrease. So it will increase the stability of complex because it will increase the covalent character of MC bond. So if carbon is a part of an unsaturated aromatic system or attached to a halogen, nitrogen or oxygen as substituent. Now, why we can think that in case of an unsaturated system, there is extended double conjugated system and this may be sp or sp2 hybridized carbon atom. In case of aromatic system, because in aromatic systems, the electrons are delocalized. They act like an electron withdrawing group. So they can withdraw the electron. So these unsaturated groups, they also withdraw electrons. So they decrease the electron density on the carbon atom. And if halogens are attached, they also withdraw the electrons. So they have a tendency, all these groups, unsaturated, aromatic system, halogens, oxygen, which are more electronegative, they decrease the density on the carbon atom. So as they decrease the density on the carbon atom, they decrease the ionic bond character of MC bond. Thus, they increases the stability of organometallic compounds. So now, the order of stability of organometallic compound can be seen like this. That if we will see the difference between these groups. So we can compare these groups. So this is CH3, this is C6H5 and this is CF3. So this is alkyl group, this is phenyl group and this is electronegative atom. So these electronegative atom, it will attract the electron shared pair electron towards itself. So decrease the electron density here. Likewise, this phenyl group, it attracts the electron towards itself and delocalize the electrons in the system. So it again decreases the electron density on this P. While in case of this, these increases the electron density, this methyl group or alkyl group, they increases the electron density on this metal, thus increases their ionic nature and thus they are more reactive, they are less reactive. So it is more stable than this and then this, it is least reactive, this is least stable species among these species. Now, in some cases, the ligand, if ligand is alkyl group, so due to presence of beta hydrogen, beta elimination takes place. So due to this beta elimination, sometimes the organometallic compound becomes unstable. But this is this is not occur in case of main group elements, except sub elements which form electron deficient compounds like lithium, magnesium, beryllium or aluminium. There can this beta elimination may occur, but in most of the cases of main group elements, this beta elimination generally it does not occur. It occur in case of transition metal alkyls. So in detail we will study this beta elimination in the stability or reactivity of transition metal complexes, transition metal alkyls. So this is just an introduction that if beta hydrogen is present in an organometallic compound, this beta hydrogen can eliminate it and this compound become unstable and it can dissociate into these two compounds, these two type of compound. And the conditions are for beta elimination, the beta H should be there, MCCH, these bond should be coplanar or vacant orbitals may be present or the compound may be electron deficient. These are the three main conditions for beta elimination, and that is present in the transition metal alkyls. It is less common in case of main group metal alkyls. So in gist or in conclusion, we can say that organometallic compounds stability or reactivity for main group elements that depends upon the ionic bond strength. So more the ionic bond strength, more will be the reactivity. And the factors that affect the ionic nature of the MC bond that are responsible for the reactive or stable nature of the organometallic compounds of main group elements.